this video, I'm going to give you a chance to look at my studio space. I'll take you around a little bit of a tour so you can get an idea of what I use for me to be able to draw the stuff that I do. First of all, I'll start with my drawing desk. I've got myself a light box and a drawing table. So I've got all sorts of various pencils, mechanical pencils. These are just odds and ends that I might need to be able to do the job properly. I've also just recently bought this, which is a TFT backlit screen. Obviously, the types of drawings that I do, they're quite in-depth and they're really high definition, so I need to be able to see the images well. I need to be able to zoom in and see them really clearly. So I found this was a really good deal online that I got for around £100. You can see a little bit of my drawings, my commissions that I've completed. As well, we've got a Rihanna, a David Bowie and a Johnny Depp. So these will probably go into a gallery fairly shortly. And also there you can see my wall chart for the year, which is pretty packed. Always good to have that because this is a business essentially, and I do spend more than 8 hours at my desk a day. So when I'm not drawing, I am on the phone or talking to prospective clients. And one of the major things that I want to talk about is get yourself a comfortable chair. Because as you know, as an artist, if you're going to be working for long periods of time, if you're going to be drawing in the same position for hours on end, and trust me, I know that we do, get yourself a comfortable chair and look after yourself, because one of the major things that I suffer with is back trouble. So you don't want that, so make sure you invest in something comfortable. So over here you can clearly see one of my most recent drawings of the Joker, Jared Leto. And I recently finished this. This took me about 2 months to complete. The bookcase is really important because not only is it where I store all of my gear that I need to do my job, we've got various things, but it also serves as a place of inspiration. So I've got various books to do with history or tales, and basically I'll just draw on these for inspiration when I'm looking to draw something new. So, you know, education is key. I'm really big on education. So we've got various books that I like to use. Some of this is my fiance's, most, and a lot of it is mine. You know, my camera there. It's a pretty decent camera. It's a Nikon. The Coolpix range, I think it's the LA10. This I bought for around £100. You can get this online. And I found this is a really, really decent camera to be able to take high quality shots of a subject or a pet that I'm going to be able to do. Draw from. Down here, as you can see, I also have my larger camera, which is a Nikon as well. And this has got a bigger optical zoom so I can get some really HD pictures in there and a really good zoom. I also use this to film my YouTube channels. So today, obviously I'm not filming with this. My cameraman and photographer, Reese, is. Say hello.
Hello.
but this is the type of thing that we use to capture the YouTube videos. Really, really good quality camera. Cost a fair bit, but it's best, I'll always say in my videos, if you want the best results, use the best equipment. Spend the money. If it's a pencil, make sure it's the best pencil that you can find. If it's a camera, get the best quality. Because people want quality, and you know, that's how your business grows. Quality products. So anyway, so that's the camera that I use. I've also got some lighting equipment in there as well. And we've also got a tripod that we use as well. I've purchased this online again. This cost me about 20 quid. But this serves as a really decent stand for the camera. Height adjustable, and it's really, really good for doing YouTube videos or vlogs or videos or anything like that. So I think that's pretty much it from me, guys. This is kind of a tour of everything that I've got. This is my studio space. If you have any questions, drop a comment, I suppose, in the comment section below, and hit subscribe if you want to see more videos. I've got a few more videos coming out soon. Some of them I'm going to be talking about materials that I use specifically, like pencils. Thanks very much, guys. Speak to you soon.